dollar bill, y'all, Claus. He's getting paid. How much? We don't know.
Another one here says, I want to see him go to Phoenix and rejoin CP3. All right. It never happened. That would be great theater.
No, I gotta be honest. The Suns don't need it. The Suns don't need it. They're grooving. They got a good young group. They got their veteran leader.
Probably a team that's playing well and nobody's talking.
Can't wait for them to fail in the playoffs. I can't wait. It's going to be so entertaining for me. Another ticket test.
Why is that?
I hate CP3.
Oh, okay. I'm like,
I never want him to win a thing.
There sounds like there's history behind it.
No, I just hate him. He's all the credit. I mean, he's good. But, you know, just don't want him ever.
Because he never takes blame for it.
You know, it's everybody else. Not him.
He has great games.
I hate those commercials. Can he get injured in a commercial?
$171 million to be in LA and be a Clipper for life.
seen reports that there's a lot of interest in this guy. $22 million cap hit. What happens with him? Should he be on this list?
Rico, go. First crack.
I think that if you can get him for really basement prices, you go and shop for him. If he's asking for top dollar, you pass. You wait until that price comes down. But if you could get him for a manageable price and or a 1 or 2 year deal, go for it.
Issue for me with Miller, 32 years old, the 22 mil off an injury. I don't know. If you're asking me to rank him, the challenge is for Ryan Miller. If I'm a contender, yeah, I'll pay him a lot of money for 1 year, but there's no way I'm doing business in a 3 or 4 year term. Not happening.
Number 8 on the list. Edge rusher Derek Barnett. It says he is entering the 5th year of his rookie contract. That will cost $10.1 billion. The Eagles were projected to be $50 million over the cap this year.
Yeah, I saw today Kelce and a host of other veterans, Darius Slay included, redoing their deals to open up some cap space for them. What I would say is this: if the Eagles drafted him and put in all the work to develop him, didn't offer him a long-term deal, then why would I want him? Now, the other way to view it, he could be Leonard Floyd. He could be the guy who goes somewhere else and really blows up. But he's an all-right player, but I don't know that that moves my needle to give up.
That's an interesting way of looking at it, Mike. I look at him as maybe he was just the odd man out, but now that you mention that, maybe Philly knows something because if they don't resign him.
Number 7 on the list, wide receiver Emmanuel Sanders. We all know he signed a deal with them last year, but they're projected at 63.5 over the cap. They have to make moves somewhere. Will he get traded?
If you can find somebody who wants him, but he's a little long in the tooth, and wide receivers, kind of a dime a dozen. He's not a number one, so
they make him better.
Yeah. I'm not giving anything up. I know the Saints are in a terrible spot. They're going to have to release a lot of people. I wouldn't do business with the Saints. I would just pilfer their corpse.
Yep.
I would just get a folding chair and just sit right outside the headquarters.
Yes. Emmanuel Sanders is walking out of the facility.
Hey, I know you.
Here's a pamphlet. Give me a call. Give me a call. Give me a call.
Phil?
Number 6 on the list. A guy that's been talked about a lot this offseason. Quarterback Teddy Bridgewater. Will he get traded this offseason?
I think he will. Probably happen after the draft because you got to see which teams took rookie quarterbacks. Basically, like it or not, you're going to help the next person come along and then take the job from him. That's where he is right now. So I think he will.
There's a market for QBs. There's more spots available, teams who need them, than there are guys who can fill those spots. So I agree with Rico here. They'll find a landing spot. It just won't be Carolina.
Well, will it be the next guy heading to Carolina? I'm surprised he's at 5 on this list. He's most likely to be traded. Number 5, QB Deshaun Watson.
Mike, let me say something real quick.
Please.
Because this is being handled so poorly. That's why he's 5. I don't think that the Texans will trade him. I think the Texans are stubborn enough
to take this season
and just say, you know what? We'll eat the cost of this year. We'll keep some of the signing bonus and we'll just go for broke. We'll see how dedicated he is, but we're going to not worry about him and let him sit out. It's an ugly game of chicken that shouldn't be being played. 100% he's going to go. He's not going to give him a chance. And you're hearing reports now. His camp's already leaking it out. Go ahead and test us. I'll hang out in Miami all 2021 season. They're going to have to trade.
You would think so. I think that Houston is just as stubborn, and they're going to say, fine, sit there. You know what? We'll come to Miami with you. We'll just be two Miami people sitting there. What do you want to drink? I don't know. What do you want to drink? Be like that one meme. You smell great. No, you smell better.
Yeah, it's a lot of noise, you're right, because even Jalen Ramsey just spoke on a podcast saying he's out. He's extremely serious about what he